So there are two stages of meiosis, meiosis one and meiosis two. In meiosis one, what happens? There is recombination and crossing over. Okay, recombination and crossing over between homologous chromosomes. Okay, what is mean by homologous chromosomes? Anybody? The chromosomes which are having, yes, pair of chromosome, Anjima, but what is the meaning of homologous? Homologous chromosomes are those chromosomes which are similar in size, similar in structure, okay, having the same number of gametes, etc., chromosomes, etc. So these are called as homologous chromosomes. What is the other name? Not sister chromatids. Okay, so they are divided into two groups, and thus two haploid cells are formed. What we get after that? We get two haploid cells. Okay, so the cell which carries only one set of chromosome, that is called as haploid. If there is two set, then what we call it as diploid chromosome. Correct. So now here, what is a haploid? This is called as a haploid chromosome. Sorry, haploid cells. Okay, I hope you understood. Okay, now the diagram, you can look at the diagram over here while I am explaining, right? So here, what I said now, cell and diploid cell, what is the difference? First let me teach you, then I will continue. Okay, now haploid cell is what? A cell which is having only one set of chromosome, correct? One set of chromosome. That means in human beings, it is on human beings is having haploid chromosome number 23. How many chromosome we are having? 23 haploid chromosome. When if it is diploid, what happens? The cells in which chromosome number is double. What is they? What are they called? Diploid cells. Now diploid chromosome in human beings will be how much, students? If haploid is 23, what is the double of 23? 46. Very good. Akansha, 46. Correct, Bhumi. So 46 chromosomes. 46 is a number of diploid chromosomes in human beings, and number of haploid chromosome in human beings is 23. So I hope it is very much clear what is the difference between haploid cell and diploid cell. The cell which contains only one set of chromosome is haploid cell, and the cell which contains two sets or double, the chromosome number is double, that is diploid cells. Okay, so now look at the diagram. Now in meiosis one, we are having four phase, that is prophase one, metaphase one, anaphase one, and telophase one. Okay, so in prophase one, again there are four stages. Okay, so we don't have to study in depth in detail about those stages, but we have to explain meiosis two, meiosis one, as it you have to write regarding the crossing over. Okay, what happens in meiosis one? The recombination or crossing over occurs between homologous chromosomes, and thereafter those homologous chromosomes, what they are doing? They are again divided into two groups, that is two haploid cells. Okay, that much only regarding meiosis one. Now when we will go more to meiosis two. Now in meiosis two also there are different stages. Like we are having prophase two. Okay, prophase two, metaphase two, anaphase two, and telophase two. Okay, so this meiosis two, in this we have to explain in this way, that it is just like mitosis. Okay, meiosis two is just like what? Mitosis. You studied mitosis last week, correct? In mitosis, you studied the four stages. So in this stage, what happens in meiosis two also? It's just like mitosis, where two haploid daughter cells, okay, two haploid daughter cells formed in meiosis one undergoes division by separation of recombined sister chromatids. Okay, so the sister chromatids will recombine, and then they will divide, and four haploid daughter cells are formed. Okay, so how many daughter cells are formed here? 4 haploid daughter cells. Now, process of gamete production and spore formation will occur. Okay, gametes are formed here, spores are formed in this stage. So, in this type of cell division, 4 haploid daughter cells are formed from 1 diploid cell. So, how you will denote the haploid and diploid? By using the alphabet N. N stands for haploid. For diploid, we will write 2N. Okay, N and 2N. Okay. So during this cell division, what happens? There will be crossing over taking place. Okay, crossing over, how it takes place? Between homologous chromosomes, the crossing over takes place, and thereby what? When the crossing over takes place, what genetic materials are combined? Genetic material will combine. That's why we call it as genetic recombination. Okay, so due to this genetic recombination, we are getting 4 daughter cells, which are genetically different from parent cell. You will not find it similar. It is different from the parent cell and also different from each other. Okay. So this is how meiosis 2 occurs. Now it will be much more clear when I will show you a short video of this. Okay. Of how this mitosis or phases of mitosis you can observe in onion rooting. Okay. That video will be useful to you. Meiosis 2 is similar to mitosis, so you will understand it better. Okay. So first we will go through the questions, then we'll watch the video. Okay. Somatic cells and stem cells divide by dash. Give the answers in the chat box. Somatic cells and stem cells divide by dash. Everyone participate. Okay, it will be useful. Okay, I got the answer from many of you. I'm reading answers. Those are not done, given the answer, give it. Okay. Correct answer, students. Mitosis. Mitosis is completed through 2 main steps. Those 2 steps are dash and dash. Mitosis is completed through 2 main steps. Very good, Manjima, Purva. Correct answers. Cytokinesis and karyokinesis. Very good. Karyokinesis is completed through 4 steps. Type the 4 answers. Question number 3. Karyokinesis is completed through 4 steps. Very good, Manjima. Prophase, metaphase, anaphase and telophase. Correct. Meiosis is completed through dash stages. Meiosis is completed through dash stages. Two stages. Very good. 2 stages. Correct, Akansha and Sneha. Both are correct. That is meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. Very good, Bhumi, Vaidehi. Okay. So you all have answered me the questions for which was given the lesson. We are completing this chapter.